हेलो, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। टुडे दिस इज़ माय थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन फायर आर्म्स एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज़ द बैलिस्टिक्स। So ballistics is basically the knowledge of the physical forces acting on the projectile or missile. And it can be simply divided into three parts. The internal ballistics, that is the ballistics which are happening within the weapon. And the external or the exterior ballistics, that is the physical forces which are acting on the projectile or the bullet when it leaves the barrel. And then terminal or the wound ballistics, that when it strikes the victim, how it produces wound. So theoretically, when we talk about ballistics, we think that the bullet, after having the internal ballistics, when it leaves the barrel, it follows a straight line. But practically, it is seen that it doesn't. Bullet does not travel into a straight line. It assumes a curved pathway. And then finally it's striking the victim and producing the wound ballistics. And this curved pathway, which it assumes, is the trajectory of a bullet. So now we'll discuss the first ballistics, that is the internal ballistics. What happened within the chamber, that is the chain of events within the chamber. The chain of events which happen within the chamber, the weapon may be smoothbore or rifled. On the left side of your screen, both the cartridges are being shown. The lower one is for the rifled weapon and the upper one is for the smoothbore weapon. The lower one is having the bullet and the upper one having the pellets. So this is the chain of events which is happening within the chamber. When the trigger is pulled, the firing pin is released and it strikes the primer cap. And within the primer cap, there is primer which ignites. And after its ignition, flame is produced, which enters into the main compartment where the gunpowder or the charge powder is. It burns. Temperature starts rising and gases starts producing, and tremendous amount of pressure starts increasing within the chamber. And this pressure then releases the bullet, and bullet is, or the pellet is, pushed forward and pushed out of the weapon. And hence the exit of the bullet happens. After the exit of the bullet, the pressure drops and it becomes almost to zero. So this is the chain of events which is occurring within the chamber. That initially the trigger is pulled, which releases the firing pin, which strikes at the base of the cartridge to the primer cap, where the primer ignites, and the flames of the primer then ignites the main powder charge, and gases starts producing. A tremendous amount of energy and pressure will be produced, which will expel the bullet or the pellets out. And after that, the pressure will fall. So this is a graphic representation that how initially the pressure rises and then it drops after the release of the bullet. So this slide will be showing that how much energy is produced within the chamber. You can see the amount of pressure which has been generated in the revolvers. It is almost 4 tons. In pistols, it is 6 tons. And in rifles, it is 20 tons. So this much amount of pressure has been generated within the chamber, and which will cause exit of the bullet, and the short charge of the bullet will start traveling in the revolvers with a speed of 600 to 900 feet per second. And in pistols, it is 1200 to 1400 feet per second. And in rifles, it is 2000 to 3000 feet per second. So this is another diagram showing the chain of events. The firing, the trigger is pulled, the firing pin striking at the base cap to the primer cap. And after the primer is ignited, it ignites the main carbon charge or main gunpowder, and then the release of the bullet. So this is the base where the primer cap is and where the firing pin strikes. And this strike, that is the physical forces, translates into chemical energy, flame. Highly explosive detonating material is present within the primer cap. It explodes, it lifts the anvil, and the flame will enter into the main chamber where the gunpowder is. And after it, ignition of the gunpowder, the gases will start producing. This is another diagram showing the primer cap. Now we talk about the external or the exterior ballistics, that is the knowledge of forces acting on the shot or projectile when it leaves the barrel till it reaches the target. So first, there are two forces which are originating by the bullet motion: the speed and rate of motion and direction of motion. This will determine the forward velocity and rotational velocity. So bullet is heading forward, traveling in forward direction, and it's rotating, rotational velocity, because the rifled weapons, they are rifled, and rifled weapons will give spin or rotational movement to the firearms, to the bullet. Whereas in smoothbore weapon, there is not a rotational velocity, is not there, only forward velocity, and unfavorable ballistics are for the smoothbore weapons. Then there are forces which are within the medium. They are the negative forces, the air resistance and the gravity. The air resistance will try to reduce the speed, alter the direction, and similarly, the gravity will pull the bullet or the pellet in downward direction. So the bullets and the pellets will not keep traveling in straight line. By the pull of the gravity, they will be pulled down and a curved pathway will be made by the bullet. So the forces originating from the projectile, the velocity, that is the speed or rate of the motion, also called the muzzle velocity. And in the rifles, this speed or velocity can be 2000 to 3000 feet per second. Then the direction of motion, forward motion, and rotational motion because of rifling. Then the bullets do not typically follow a straight line to the target, and they show various atypical movements like yaw, precession, or nutation. yaw is that the tips dips up and down during the flight. Then precession in rotating upon around its own axis. During forward movement, it also rotates along its own axis. Then nutation is repeatedly revolving around its own axis, that is called nutation. So these are atypical movements which a bullet shows during its travel during the air. Now the forces which are present in the medium, they are the negative forces, the air resistance and the gravity. And when the bullet is fired, it does not follow a straight line, but it assumes a curved pathway. And that is known as the trajectory of a bullet. So the trajectory of a bullet is a curved pathway which a bullet assumes during its flight within the air. And it does not travel in straight line because of the air resistance, because of the pull of the gravity, it assumes a curved pathway. So as soon as the bullet leaves the barrel, its forward motion is interfered by the air resistance and by the downward pull of the gravity. And this curved pathway which the bullet assumes is called trajectory of the bullet. This is a diagrammatic representation. You can see the aim is in the straight line, but the bullet does not hit in a straight line. It hits a bit lower than the actual sight of the angle. And this depends upon the distance between the weapon and the target. As the distance increases, the rate of drop will be more. And as the distance is close, the rate of drop of line of flight will be less. So a specific mechanism is adopted to overcome this curved pathway that is called zeroing. That to make the bullet to strike accurately at the target, this is done by zeroing. That with the repeated practice firing, the sight of angle of the weapon is adjusted such that that curved pathway is covered up. That drop of the bullet is covered up in that sight of the angle. So the sight of angle is a bit raised, that when you see, you are aiming the target and covering that drop, the curved pathway. So with the help of repeated practice firing, by adjusting the sight of the angle, you overcome that trajectory, that curved pathway, and that is called as zeroing, that you make the weapon zero, striking at the bull. So that is to overcome the trajectory, the curved pathway. And similarly, the ballistic coefficient is a phenomena which is that how efficient is a weapon is. When the air is offering resistance, there are certain characteristics or mechanisms or methods which have been adopted to overcome this resistance. That means they are reducing the air resistance, and that is the ballistic coefficient. How less is the ballistic coefficient means how efficient is the projectile to overcome that air resistance. And this will help in the projectile to hit the target and overcome the trajectory. And what are the processes which are adopted? They change the shape of the bullet. Instead of rounded tip, they make sharp acute angle. The jacketing, that is the another layer of alloy is added to the rough lead surface to make it smooth. Then the rifling is another mechanism which gives the spin or gyroscopic movement to overcome the resistance. So these are various methods which are adopted to overcome the air resistance and reduce the ballistic coefficient. Study the wound. Thank you very much. Take care.